Welcome back. You know what? No wonder the government is trying to make it easier to join a union. Looks like they need the help. The latest numbers out today showing that unions' share of the overall workforce dropped again last year. And that's the lowest rate ever. But DEMOS senior fellow Rich Benjamin says, you know what? When the economy gets stronger, unions will too. So what did you make of this news, Rich?
Part of it didn't surprise me. I think there are fewer jobs and therefore fewer union members. But also, unions are struggling to find their footing in a 21st century economy, just like workers are, just like businesses are, and small business owners. So part of those numbers reflect that.
Yeah, so the drop-off was from government workers, right, being laid off, government cutbacks. That's also partly behind the drop-off in the numbers, right?
Partly, but not
partly,
entirely.
But not entirely. But we're seeing unionization coming in the construction industry, right, and in other industries as well, no?
We are, but again, there are fewer construction jobs.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying. Now, Richard, the issue is that there's about 20 million workers in government, and they're unionized, and they pull in about $1.5 trillion in benefits and salary, and basically pension costs, health costs, those salaries are drowning state budgets and other governments across the country. Is this why union membership is declining, besides the layoffs?
No, I don't think so at all. You know, Newt Gingrich is a former government worker. He's also a millionaire. We don't see him declining his pension. But most government workers are not.
But he's not unionized now.
He's not unionized, but he's not, you know, we have millionaires like that who aren't declining their pension, and yet they're bashing unions. But most union members and most government workers are not millionaires like Newt Gingrich. The point being that they need unions, they need their pensions, otherwise how would they stay afloat?
So do you think that, you know, when elected officials, basically make a lot of money, I don't think Newt Gingrich was in a union when he was in Congress. He was basically getting a nice, sweet, you know, retirement package, right? But you're saying, are you saying that when union workers who work for a government get really high salaries, a lot, you know, a pension, maybe they should give it back to the government because they don't deserve it?
If they're bashing government, if they're bashing pensions, if they're bashing unions, definitely they should give it back, because that's how they got the pension in the first place. The point being that the middle class have gotten a lot of the benefits they need, the pensions, the workers' comp, the rights, because of unions. You know, now unions have to figure out how they're going to move forward. And that's why Newt Gingrich has a pension.
But Richard, do you think that unions, though, have been kind of irrational, not acknowledging the abuses that have happened with unions? In other words, it's taken for granted to spike pensions. You know, you basically declare yourself, you know, work a lot of overtime, or to get disability pay before you retire. You know, you basically, you know, make pretend that you broke a finger or something when you didn't, just to get that disability pay. In other words, are unions too slow to recognize the fact that, you know what, maybe on our watch we did let it slip? We did basically see abuses and turn the other way just to keep our positions in government.
I think, A, that type of fraud is overrated and overstated, and certain people in the media like to play it up. And union members.
You sure about that? I mean,
one
in five state troopers declare disability, for example, in California, you know, right before retirement, so they can get double pay. I mean, there's that going on across the country. You don't think it's not, do you think it's not reported enough, or it's overstated, really, when it's tax dollars going toward these abuses?
It becomes a way in a billy club to beat unions over the head. You know, this fraud, these isolated incidents, these anecdotal, oh, this person cheated the system, this person cheated the system. But by and large, people would be steamrolled by businesses, by corporations, if they didn't have someone who's skilled at negotiating for their rights.
Are unions really about just protecting workers who are really unproductive? Isn't that an issue, too, that there's lack of productivity in union workers?
My sense is that unproductive people in this economy will be tossed by the roadside.
Is that what's happening now with government workers?
With government workers? Well, the government could be more efficient. Like many businesses, government could be more efficient. And I don't know that it's the union's job to solve the problem. Perhaps it's the government agency's job to solve the problem. But I don't think the government is any less efficient than any part.
Yeah, I hear what you're saying. Richard, you're so thoughtful, and I really appreciate what you're saying. But I just think that the middle class is overtaxed out there. Property taxes are rising. Those state and local taxes tend to go toward state workers and government unions and government union benefits that some would say, you know what, it's not fair. You know, we have in the private sector, for example, deal with a 401k. There's nothing in the law that says a government worker doesn't have to have a 401k. The structure of the pension payout can change to a 401k, but, you know, you have to give them the benefit. Would you be for that?
Well, I'll tell you what I am for. I am for, by the way, if I'm a member of the Authors Guild, which is a fancy hoity-toity union,
okay.
I would be steamrolled by Google, I would be steamrolled by Amazon if the Authors Guild weren't looking out. And it's the same with the TV personality. Okay. Like, if you didn't have an agent,
I don't have an agent, quite frankly.
Well, Bill O'Reilly has an agent.
Maybe I should get one.
Yes.
Maybe I need one.
To stand up for you. Otherwise, you know, the big way. Anyway, this is.
And they take a nice chunk out of my salary, Richard. But anyway, I hear what you're saying.
Yeah.
You're always wonderful, Richard Benjamin, union expert. So good to be with you tonight. Thank you so much for your time. Have a good weekend.
Thank you, Liz.
Next up.